No, you're good. You're good.
Right, so we're running the double shield, double sniper, Bap Zen, kind of standard on Junkertown. They're running double shield, they're running Widowmaker, Genji, which is interesting. Because of their comp, we know that their Genji is going to be playing very slow, very passive, holding at angles with the shield and probably just trying to poke and playing around ult. It's interesting that they run the Genji here. It must be a comfort pick. To be fair, Genji is a direct counter to our snipers, so potentially we could see him playing quite aggressive in some stages, just depending on your positioning. You need to try and make it hard for him to get any value on our snipers if he does decide to go aggressive. They're running a Genji without an Ana as well, so playing around Blaze might not be the strongest strategy. They can't even cycle Nano Blades. He's gonna have to Dry Blade every single fight. So this is why I think the Genji pick is particularly interesting. Obviously, you want to hold high grounds predominantly. You want to enable your snipers to get those angles, right? We need to make sure our snipers can get angles which allow us to sort of peek and potentially get picks. That will be your job. You are almost secondary initiator. You need to recognize when you're getting given space. You need to rotate into that space, along with Orisa. Obviously, I say along with Orisa, I mean in terms of timing, not necessarily the same angle. You don't want to be holding the same angle as Orisa. You just want to be walking roughly at the same speed as her. I have no issue with you walking straight like in front of cart here. You know that Orisa is going to be escorting cart for now, and you also know that one of your snipers will potentially want to hold this high ground here. So in my opinion, it's worth even holding these stairs just to make sure your Hanzo is able to get a couple of shots off, etc. I would personally have chosen this route up here. It's decent, and also you can potentially run or rotate here, which means that you're further up. Easier rotation to this next high ground as well. Nothing necessarily wrong with what you do, but a lot of the times when I coach, I speak about, okay, you're getting value from this situation, how can I get more value from another situation? That is not right. Okay, fine. Okay, I like how you're going for that angle though. But remember, you're going for the angle and you're actually doing stuff. You're forcing them to move. Remember that your main job is to enable your snipers. Your snipers are now having to play main, I believe. He's probably gonna like jump shot or something like that, or just find that high ground. But yeah, from this little angle here, yeah, sure, you can get value. But can your snipers necessarily get value if they're looking at the same angle as you? They can't even see heads from here. You're lucky because your projectiles, they ricochet, they explode. So yeah, just be thinking about that. Just be thinking about that. Are you noticing that now you're playing around here, whereas if you took this initial high ground, you'd actually be able to be on the high ground and still take the exact same angle? Yeah, just think about that. Right now you're in not the greatest of positions. They have the power position because they have high ground. I guess it's a Sig versus Sig. You can still hit him clearly. High ground doesn't mean as much in a Sig versus Sig battle because it's not like you can just aim at your head, you know what I mean? You're doing the same damage to each other as long as you can still hit each other. The issue is when he starts getting help from his BAP and the BAP also starts shooting down your head. That is when you can die extremely quickly and you don't want that. Obviously, you don't want that. Know when to rotate. As in, know when to disengage. You had an opportunity to disengage. Okay, you're poking, you see he's about to get assisted. In my opinion, this is where you disengage, but instead you
step
forward.
Yeah, but then I went up. Yeah.
Now, you may even survive here. I doubt that you will. You might.
I think I do. But yeah, no, I should have came out earlier.
We use lamp on you. We've used an entire clip. Mega's using an entire clip of heals on you as well. You want to avoid using unnecessary resources. You could have made it a lot easier for yourself with better positioning. I'm not going to lie. Now, this is your best rotation so far. Okay, you realize you're not winning that fight there. They're even rotating outwards. But now you recognize Orisa's there. We can rotate either under here or even to, like, high ground. I want to see what you do with this. Because you can still get a nice angle with an assist from your Zen. This is way too aggressive, in my opinion. I don't know. Actually,
I thought the Zen would just, like, walk with me, to be honest.
Yeah. But you've pushed up. You've even jumped off the high ground. You've gained quite a bit of distance from your rotation outwards. If you want to take this angle, you want to be taking it from back here so you can jiggle, peek, and poke. Jiggle, peek, and poke. Jiggle, peek, and poke. Also, rotate away. Because the second you rotate here, you're in complete safety. They have to pass through your entire team. Way too aggressive of an angle. I believe that this could potentially work solely based on the fact that their Orisa is one. And that is not anything to do with anything that you planned. I believe you are very lucky. We get the pick on the Orisa. And now all of a sudden, it's Sigma who's in the terrible position and not you. Do you see how that would work? Because we can now create like a crossfire. Orisa shoots here whilst you're having a casual 1v1 with him. And now we're two up. I think you got really lucky with the concept. And you shouldn't die here. Poor positioning from you. But it worked out. I don't think you needed to be so hyper fixated on killing that one Genji. I mean, you were chasing him around, and I guess your Hanzo is low. I also thought that you could have potentially stayed on high ground a lot longer. I don't know if you were planning on like trying to body block your Hanzo or stuff like that, which I guess is viable. But I also think that Genji took a bit too long to die there. But yeah, these are very small. A lot of the times when I'm like analyzing gameplay, it sounds all negative, but really I'm only really searching for the negatives. If you make a play that I think is really like highly intelligent or something like that, I'll make sure I praise you for that as well. But I don't think you played all that badly, but definitely there's definitely things that you can do to get an extra edge, and it might have helped us like win this map. Well, okay, right. So this is fine. The angle you took is fine. You dealt nice damage, but like, why are you holding W? Like, there's no. You do. Where you are now, you do the exact same damage where you are compared to where I am right now on the camera, you know? And you're safer where I am on the camera. You always need to set up your fights where you can rotate out. If you were standing slightly in front of the Hanzo right now, then the positioning would be perfect. Your bullets, your projectiles are enough to push them away. We've gotten a pick on the Zen, and we really don't need to chase their enemy Widow, even though she's low. But getting a bit too aggressive. Again, no need to chase. Oh my gosh, we've taken way too much damage. Activating the barrier. And even now that you're low, you still like... You're deciding not to just chill out here for a second where your healers are, and now this means that your healer has to step out more, peek more, just to heal you up, which puts her in danger. Remember, we're playing against the Widowmaker. The Widowmaker didn't quite die. Bap could die extremely easily if you're not aware of these certain things. I appreciate the fact that you tried. You set yourself up in a position where you can body block, and you also shielded off the Widowmaker. That's the priority target to shield off, because she's the only one that can kill instantly. So that was a good play from you. I thought that it was good that you were trying to shoot the Sig. You were prioritizing the Sig. He was in the worst position. He's the one that can take damage from behind as well. So it makes sense. Unfortunate that you pop your rock just before he flux.
Yeah.
Take your time when you're, but in engagements like that, when you'll definitely get the kill, there's no need to rush shots, because you're just keeping them up for longer than they would be. Like, if you didn't miss the time it takes to chill out for half a second, the time it takes to compose yourself for half a second is actually quicker than the time it will take for you to go through the whole animation of missing your two shots and then go through another again. Yeah. It triggers my, I don't know, it irritates me. It irritates me that you go into fights not on full health when you really could have healed up before. And I know you're basically full health, but it's just like, please. Like, every health point is so valuable. Also, I don't like this position that you're playing in. Yeah, okay, you're in a good position if the cart was, like, here. You know, like, you've got a good line of sight on everything. Okay, I don't know why it's doing that now. You've got a good line of sight of everything, but where are your healers?
They can't see me?
They can't see you. You play hyper-aggressively, way too aggressively. You need to think, as an off-tank, off-tank is the role where you have to think the most about the positioning of your team and base your engagements, base your position around where your teams are. Main support as well. Main support and off tank are the two roles where you have to be aware of your position. Even though the Zen could potentially get an orb on you before you die, that's nothing. You need to be hyper aware of where your flex support is. Right now, for whatever reason, she's on cart. Which means there's no chance of you getting healed. Now you're discorded. Widowmaker is to the right of you. You're going to have to take down your shield. There will be a time where Widowmaker has a free shot on you when you're trying to rotate outwards, if you do actually try and rotate outwards. You're so lucky that the flex support managed to... We spoke about this. Mega actually pushes up. The only time Mega really pushes up is when someone's low. I don't know, but you want to avoid that. Like, there's no point. There's no point in taking damage. Like, there's no point in charging up our ult charge if you're charging up theirs as well, you know? Window is not a high value ult. It just simply creates space. Against the team comp that's set up in two different angles, you're only taking space against one of their angles as well. So window becomes quite obsolete in that sense. I guess, okay.
I think the reason I pushed here, like, especially early, was just because I knew that our team was coming in and I didn't want them to already be, like, set up comfortably by the time we start, like, getting cart over there, you know? So I think that's the reason why. This was, like, a few days ago, so I'm not maybe remembering everything exactly, but like, I think that was the thought process, was like, I don't want them to set up for free. Like, I want to be up here and like make it difficult for them to control this, you know?
It makes sense. Taking space is really important. However, I can tell that you didn't necessarily communicate that because the team weren't expecting it. Your team weren't expecting you to take such an aggressive angle. They took quite a while for them to actually assist you. Megal wouldn't have been escorting Carr if you had communicated the fact that you were going to push up. She would have followed you.
Yeah.
But I guess that's just down to comms. Feel like you maybe rushed out Flux, but I don't think it was a terrible Flux. I feel like you could have got more line of sight. You did it half behind the wall is what I'm saying. But
I did it so I could see the rock came out on my left. Like, I didn't want to get rocked.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
That's kind of why I was just, like, playing the corner a little.
This is lost anyway, so I don't really care if you die.
Yeah.
But, now, I don't want to see you pushing in before the whole team is ready to reload. Someone needs to get the payload moving. You looked back, but you didn't look back far enough to, like, for long enough to see if your main tank was there. Once again, you push in. Okay, now, you know where they're set up? Your position is fine. I'm just gonna say your position is fine. If you put, like, a couple projectiles up there in that direction, that's fine. But I really do not want to see you go up these stairs. If I see you go up these stairs, I'm gonna be annoyed. Perfect. Okay, you got a pick, and now you're pushing up the stairs. I think you're pushing up the stairs slightly too early. I feel like you're lucky that Brazel also got like a pick. Slightly too early. Good idea, wrong timing. Yeah, I feel like in my opinion on the SIG, you want to try and not necessarily avoid head-on engagements, which you seem to like doing. You seem to like getting into these head-on engagements. As SIG, I would rather you just play around ult, trying to poke to be annoying and enable your teammates, as opposed to trying to frag out or distract. I feel like you're indirectly doing a really good distracting their enemy SIG and distracting people, which allows your team to pop off like indirectly, but it doesn't help them get high value positions or angles or any of that. I get like your style of play, I guess it's fine if the whole team understands that that is the strategy we're playing for, distractions as and a late engagement from the snipers, as opposed to okay setting up our snipers for those high value angles. The team isn't aware of the fact that, okay, this is how we're going to get the most value in this situation based on the fact that you're playing. Your team is still expecting you to allow them to take angles, and that's why you'll see that Punks is constantly sort of trailing behind you, trying to push in with you, because without you, he won't be able to do anything. You'll notice Punks stays by you a lot. You push through, whoa. You're on 176 health at the time. You push through this Orisa shield into a sniper whilst you're discorded. Okay, right, we push through this pretty easily. Yeah, you called back your shield. You step forward, look directly at the sniper. You're a headshot away from death, and your head hitbox is bigger than a squishy. Don't take that engagement.
Okay.
You also struggled. You fought so hard to take this high ground, just to jump off of it. Like... Wait.
I think, I'm pretty sure at this point, I forget who it was, but, like, someone was telling me to push the Widow, which is, like, why I went for it. But I forget, to be honest, this was a few days ago.
If that's the case, that's fair enough. Cause
Like, they were, like, telling me specifically, you know what I mean?
Cool. If that's the case, that's fair enough. Cause the worst thing you can do is try and counter calls.
But also, I did think that I would take it. I mean, like, they were calling the Megas hack, like, she can't heal and stuff, so.
Winnable. We're lucky we won this retrace, which I guess is our win con anyway, but, like. Where did you go?
I went back up and then we just lost, so I died.
You overly aggress a lot. I think that's your biggest fault. Positioning. Positioning's poor because you overly aggress. The universe is magnificent. I don't know. I wouldn't say you're a selfish player, but you play in almost a selfish way. Where you're not really thinking about, like. How do I say this? Not necessarily that you're not thinking about, like, the bigger picture and or thinking about, like, your team, but you're not really planning around your team's positioning. You're just planning around, okay, how can I get value? You're trying to get the most value that you possibly can. And at times, you're getting value, but really, your team as a whole, you're more likely to win if everyone has value. If you have 100 value, let's just say in digits, like 100 worth of this value. It's better if everybody else overall has just 20 value, you know what I mean? Like, if you can get less value, but it means that someone else on your team can get more, everyone at the end of the day has more value and we're more likely to win the fight, even though you might necessarily have worse stats, you might not necessarily get as many fluxes in a fight. Your team will get more picks. The good thing about this comp is we have good pick potential. Obviously, we switched on to the Sombra now. I haven't seen our Hanzo, for example, get that many picks, get that many headshots. And that's down to you, in a way. That's down to you just not enabling him. But I wouldn't say it's completely down to you, but you're definitely like an effect.
Yeah.
Might be worth, yeah. Okay. Good ability usage there. Good ability usage. You sure, like, your grasp ability quite well. That is quite a huge chance as well. In this situation, I would genuinely just stay. Cart. Escort cart. Push the cart. I feel like this is where we get the most value. In these little brawls, I see you go in front of the shield, you're damaging their frontline Orisa. To be honest, like, if I was you, I would have just changed target to the Widow. I would at least stop her from peeking. Sombra's on. But yeah, you could have done like a fairly decent amount of damage. If you hit both orbs on the Widowmaker, then Sombra 100% of the time like wins this fight, you know? Unless Widowmaker aims in and one taps her, which is
not common.
Not common, but at that point, like, she deserves it. You know, like, she actually deserves to win the fight. But yeah. Why did we EMP?
Yeah, that was questionable. It's playing again.
That's a big one. missed out a lot. Nice high value angle. Unlucky that you couldn't finish that off.
Yeah. And then I accidentally dropped.
Again, by doing that, you got a lot of value from that. By doing that, as you're doing it, I want you to scream that you need, like, heals. Because, again, I noticed that you weren't really receiving all that much heals. But in that situation, like, I genuinely think that you made the correct play. Like, games won't get won if people don't make micro plays like that. So, just make sure you're screaming for those resources there. If you got hard pumped by everything, then we would have... Literally, you know, like, we would have won just because you managed to, like, aggress onto it. Tall weirdos. You didn't even... Was Sig in your line of sight?
No, I was like, maybe he's around the corner, so I literally had no idea. He was right there, actually. I didn't see him, though.
Nah, you wouldn't have been able to see him. That's fine. I like how you grasped the second you landed as well, because they're definitely going to put bullets into you if you're on half health. You got quite a lot of value from that. I like to see stuff like that. Don't switch your targets. There's no need to look at a ball when people are like half and you're shooting them on Sig. Like, no need to look at a ball. People will sort that out. Ball's gonna stay alive the longest, you know? Like, no matter what. So, just let him be for now. Don't switch your targets. In this situation, I'd probably, like, fixate on the Zen and be like, I'm killing that Zen before I do anything else.
Yeah, we just lost our supports right here.
And then we called for, like, a soft reset, I think.
Yeah, in this little mega.
Nice. Good set of pills there. Our damage output in this fight has been really good. We got a flux back quite quickly. I also noticed that your shield was, like, splitting the McCree LOS, so they wouldn't have got that flash off. But, unlucky. Unlucky that they managed to.
Can you go back to before our supports died? On, like, the last part? Yeah, like, right before this. Like, go, like, 20 seconds before this. Yeah, like, right here. So play it a little bit, I'll tell you when.
I'm gonna do it slower speed as well.
Yeah, that's cool. I wanna go back to the part where you were talking about, like, not switching, my target focus. So I feel like here, like, pause now. Go back, like, one thing. When I get to this part here, like, before I start moving back to the middle, I don't know if you saw, like, I was basically behind that corner on the right. Mm-hmm. I feel like potentially just, like, holding that corner right there and, like, forcing out the Kree would also be, like, a very good play right there. I don't know if you, like, press back, like, the... Yeah, so, like, go back one. And, like, look where I'm at. And then I'd go over to where that Kree is, basically. I didn't, like, process this, like, while it was happening, but just, like, watching it back right now.
Yeah, I think I noticed this as well.
Like, if I go, like, right here, if I, like, pressure that McCree out or something, or even just hold that corner right there, I don't know. I feel like it maybe potentially could have gone differently.
He's discorded right now by the enemy then. That's what I want to know. Oh, Mega dies quick. Mega's gonna die. Yeah, so what I'm thinking is, if you aggress onto the Han up, Kree right now.
Like these two back here. I don't know. I might. Yeah. I don't know.
Like, I fancy your chances. Like, Sigma's a good, like, duelist. Like, he'll win one fight. Yeah, it's not likely that he'll win a 1v2, but he can win a 1-on-1. So if you go for the Kree, McCree's attention gets diverted. Fine. Possibly you win that fight. I also think that Zenyatta's
probably gonna look at me too.
Zenyatta will look at you as well.
Mm-hmm.
And that means, okay, Discord's not on Mega. Mega's positioning right now is awful. So she
yeah, I don't know how she got there.
Yeah, yeah.
Probably from the Flux or something. Yeah. Probably from the Flux. That's my only guess.
But yeah, yeah. So at least Discord won't be on anyone else other than you. And I guess, like, it's better if it's on you than on our Baptiste. Definitely, I would have tried poking that out. I do think that that angle is slightly better, especially since we were even numbers or just down one at the time. We could have evened that up. I say even it up, like, we still would have been down a BAP and they would have been down a Kree. Like, that trade off pretty much means nothing to us. Like, we're still down in numbers, basically, but.
Right.
But yeah. But
yeah, and then we saw how the rest of this played out.
Mm-hmm. Like, I have no real advice there. I just see that shield and I see you, like, AD strafing behind the shield and I think, like, what are you actually doing here? My only advice would be, like, this is just unnecessary. I guess, like, I don't really know what more you can be doing on Sig other than, like, maybe having a shield for your Hanzo and just letting that be. A shield in this position here will take less damage because right now not many people can see it.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, that's all I can give for that. Like, again, I just think it was a bit unnecessary.
Yeah, we're just poking.
That's fine. You don't want to give him too much space. You don't want to give him too much space. This is fine, yeah. You stop them from sort of, or you delayed their tank line from pushing up at least by doing that. Okay, they're gonna be stupid. Positioning a lot better on defense. I feel like on defense it's a lot easier to understand where to take fights.
Yeah,
because
I agree.
You just set up. Attack, you have to sort of outsmart a setup, whereas defense it's just okay, we set up and now we hold it.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, your positioning so far has been a lot better on defense and you haven't really been overly aggressive. The thing is, on defense, Sigma, oftentimes aggressive positions are the high value ones. So by this I feel like you're actually doing quite a lot. It's not ideal that they are on either side of you now. Still, you still want to have that idea of being able to rotate outwards. Like I said, okay, you're taking this fight here, but you're Sig, you can literally take this exact same fight here. Like,
yeah.
Orisa's only now going out of your range on Sig. Like, only now. Like, you would have been dealing damage, and at least if as soon as the BAP comes around, you can just hold A and B behind here. But, yeah. Because you use those rotations anyway. You use that rotation anyway, so why don't you just take the fight here? At least that way, if you press yourself against this wall, you'll even be out of LOS slightly. Your hitbox will definitely be at least split in half. They'll only be able to see the right side of your body if you hard hug that wall. If that. You might have been completely concealed. I don't even know. Mechanics could be better.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of the times, high level players or higher level players stop focusing on mechanics because they think, okay, I've climbed. I'm one of the best players. I'm one of the best players on this entire game. Why do I need to keep focusing on mechanics? Like, I know you're a 3-8 peak, but that's what, like, top 3% or something like that? Like, it's still high. You're still one of the best players. You're one of the best Overwatch players in NA. You know what I mean? Even though you haven't necessarily hit that Grandmaster level, you're still, like, a lot better than the average. So don't take that for granted. Don't stop focusing on mechanics. Always try and grind out mechanics. Try and make sure you're testing yourselves in either practice range or anything, especially if you struggle, particularly on the Sigma. If you feel like his projectile speed is like more difficult than I don't know, it, like maybe you're good at tracking with D.Va, for example. Like, don't just stop focusing on grinding out mechanics because they're really important. You also want to don't rely on the splash damage. You want to be trying to hit those directly. You want to try and hit those directly. That's fine. Yeah, I would have engaged like half a second earlier with the rock, but nice if you forced that. That's a decent kill. We've now put more, way more, and we've got no value. This wasn't a mistake of yours. This was a mistake of the entire team. We lose that. Yeah, that was terrible. That was terrible. Not you. That was just everyone. God, that was so bad. We forced out their ult early, and then we Chan for no reason. We Dragon for no reason. Like, what? Oh, this was Brazel's end. Like, you think he'd know how to pop a defensive ult if he's a main support, but I guess not.
Does he normally play the BAP here?
We're sort of still deciding. Like, oh. We came up with the conversation yesterday.
Yeah, I remember that actually.
Yeah. Like, Brazel, I don't know. Brazel, I think, is mechanically... No, I wouldn't even say mechanically better, because if you look at Mega play, Mega actually hits her shots, like, very, very consistently. But, Mega is very, she's very scared of making mistakes, and that sort of holds her back. I feel like you're the opposite. Like, I feel like you're the opposite. But, yeah. Like, okay, cool. Perfect angle. But you were shooting at an Orisa shield when Widow was on cart. Like, you shot, like, twice at the Orisa shield before you shot at the Widowmaker. And then you switched to the Widowmaker.
Was the Widow there already? I don't know if I saw her. Yeah, she was. Yeah, I could have killed her. I think that's when I noticed her, is when I switched. And then...
That's fine. You want their back to be doing stuff like that. Don't get pressured out by it either. Again, like... I feel like in terms of the decisions that you made, it was a good decision. But having said that, looking back on it, I was just tunnel visioning through your point of view, and then I turn around and I see the entire backline is dead. Is there something
I don't know
more?
What happened over here. Let's see.
No, you're set up quite well. Your snipers are using the Orisa shield. It's just our team awareness is terrible. Brazel realizes now. Apparently doesn't call it out because nobody turns.
No one turns, yeah.
Oh my
then
god.
Then they flux our team.
How do you manage to get sneak attacked in Overwatch? Like, it's Overwatch. How do you manage to rotate a whole team around without you realizing at this level? Again, really bad play. That wasn't your fault. Brazel just didn't call it for some reason. Not even Brazel turned around. When he took damage from Vayne, he didn't even turn around. He didn't think, oh, someone stay away. But... Brigitte at your service. God, that makes sense. So I've noticed that your positioning actually isn't bad. It's just your positioning on attack. I feel like you struggle to rotate inwards. I feel like my best advice to use to describe Sigma is not like the main initiator. He's more of the sneaky initiator. Okay, you're the one that wants to be looking for the high ground. It's not the Orisa that wants to do that. It's you. You just need to try and be annoying, poke out.
Was that, by the way, too, I know, like you mentioned earlier, too, like, not stacking on the Orisa, but on this, like, third point, I feel like, not maybe necessarily stacking, but, like, both holding up there is, like, how we would play that, right?
Yeah, nothing in this game is, like, objective. So if I say, oh, don't never stack up with the Orisa, it doesn't mean, like, never.
It doesn't mean, like, literally with... never. Yeah. No, I know that. No, I know that.
Never stack up with the Orisa unless you're Junker Town third point defense. It's just easier to say. Yeah.
I know what you mean. But I'm saying, like the place where I was holding, obviously I pushed a little, I think, too much there, but...
It's also viable for Orisa to be playing down here, but yeah, as Sig, you always want to be holding here. And yeah. If the Orisa wants to join you, then I guess, yeah, sure, Orisa, just stack if you want. But the good thing about this angle is, if we really need to, we just drop down. Like, just drop down, and then we take the fight close. And then, if we take a close fight, like a brawl distance fight on this comp, it solely comes down to mechanics. Like, it solely comes down to mechanics. Neither of our team have any brawl potential. I would say that our team potentially has more, because we have the Hanzo, the Genji, and the Brig. Hanzo, you see really weird brawl comps with Hanzo. Like it's not impossible to see that. Genji is obviously a dive character. Dive is played very, very similar to brawl. It's very close range. Genji excels in that situation. And Brig just swings. Like, that's literally her whole character arc. But
was that a misplay for me to push that doorway, by the way? When they were up there on the stairs.
So from like before, here?
Before I got knocked down. And it was before I got knocked down. This is after I dropped.
Oh, yeah.
So, like, if you watch this. Because I saw we got... I forget who we picked first. But, like, we got a early pick.
Yeah, this is weird. Like, okay, maybe not the idea itself. Because you're closing down space. The rotation where you drop shield, you rotated on... You're gonna be getting all that poke. You're gonna get all. Oh my god, he is like super charged up. His brother's on 771 health.
Yeah.
What? Oh, yeah, it's a misplay. Like, yeah. It's a misplay if you look at it that way. Oh my god. I would have tagged him once, saw his health, and gone scared.
Yeah, then I started backing, but he had rock.
How did he die?
We ended up still killing him. Yeah, we still killed him right away. What the? I want to watch him for a sec. Maybe because when he did that, he was rocking me and didn't have shield. I don't know.
He genuinely had 800 health. He genuinely had 800 health.
Let's see. Oh, we had Bongo up too, but I think because he went to rock me or something, I don't know. So he didn't have shield. Yeah, he didn't have shield, see?
He took 400 damage instantly twice in a row.
Yeah.
That is so unfortunate. Like, so unfortunate. I would be so annoyed.
You're like, my man, I had 800 health. What just happened?
Like, the power of like storm arrows, isn't it? Storm arrows through a window, like you'll just die. It's like 140 damage roughly every second. Probably even shoots more than one a second. Definitely does that. That's a nice engagement. Do you notice that you're actually doing stuff, playing a passive position right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, like, you're this is what I want you to do the entire game.
I see it.
That's fine, but there's actually no need to push on it. Like, you can just go back.
Yeah, no, I was just maybe thought there were people on my guy. Then I tried to hold here, which I don't think was the right idea.
It's fine because you have flux. You can potentially get out. Yeah. So just don't push through.
Right. Then we trance, so now we just walk.
Okay, I wouldn't call this overcommitting just simply based on the fact that people are still dying somehow. You rock this, I have faith.
Oh. Close. I wasn't sure if I did or not. I forgot. The equations were correct. The problem must lie elsewhere. So, but let me know if you think this is accurate. I think overall, like my sig is like not bad. I just need to learn when to like stop being so aggressive.
Yeah. And refining your mechanics would be nice as well.
Yeah.
Brushing up on them. Because being mechanically strong is quite important for off tank players. Like, you right. actually have to focus on that quite a bit. Whereas me, I'm a main support player, and my worst support is literally Mercy. So, like, mm-hmm. It's not even like I need to do anything. Brig's easy, it's just combos and, like, you know, literally just combos. That's all to Brig. And then like Lucio, I'm a Lucio main, so that's just easy for me. But yeah, off tank you kind of need mechanics. The Zarya is hard, D.Va's hard. Sig is probably the easiest off tank to learn in terms of mechanics.
I feel the opposite, to be honest. Like really? I feel like he's harder. Yeah. Like personally, like I think like it's way easier for me to play Zarya. Or
so
like even
I can tell you're not a huge fan of projectiles.
No, it's not that. It's just like I haven't played Sig as much as the others, so that's why it's like not as easy for me. Like I used to play like mostly projectile DPS before I started playing off tank again, but like I played a lot of Pharah and Hanzo.
Oh, okay. My one's weird. I play Pharah and Hanzo are my best DPS. Mm-hmm. The only off tank in the entire game I can play is D.Va. I feel like that's just because right now my tank is like diamond level, so like people don't use their brains. It's kind of easy to read it, and like I'm not good at tracking. So Zarya is probably my worst hero in the entire game.
I feel that. No, my tracking is actually very bad, except on Zarya for some reason. Like I can't play soldier, but I can play Zarya.
I play on a high sense as well, which doesn't help.
Oh yeah, that makes it harder for sure.
Yeah. Big wrist aimer. That's why I just what Brig Lucio T trick? High sense doesn't really matter. High sense doesn't matter when you're with Lucio T trick. But yeah. I can play Zen as well, weirdly. I don't know how that came about, because I can't aim on anyone in this game other than Zen. But
that's interesting.
Yeah. Probably just, I played a lot of Zen on console. I just probably know, like, the bullet speed or whatever, the projectile mm-hmm. speed, so I'm just used to it. I'll flex anyone, but we'll probably lose. I have an issue with you holding that angle there, no, because you saw all of them, like, you actually saw all of them rotating.
Yeah, yeah, I should have backed.
Disengagement a lot earlier, yep. And now you're down yep. one, and you're off high, okay, you'll be back.
I think I messed it up.
Yeah, I actually quite struggle to do this, I'm not even gonna lie.
I don't know how, I don't know why, but, like, whenever I'm on, like, tanks, it's just harder, but, like, other heroes, it's easy to do it.
Yeah,
but then we just pop off anyway, so oh we won this map, I didn't know that. But yeah.
I can do it when I'm playing Brig. It's really easy on Brig.
You get a third person to help you out.
Yeah. And also a shield bash jump, which kinda helps a lot more. But Yeah, that VOD lasted quite a bit longer than my VODs usually last. So, hopefully I highlighted stuff to you.
Yeah. No, I think the biggest thing that I took was just like calming down the aggression a little bit, and just especially on attack, like figuring out like when to engage and also not going too far.
One thing that I want you to think about is enabling your teammates as well. So
Yeah.
not only being passive, but by being, understand that by being passive, you're enabling people to actually pop off themselves, as opposed
Right.
to having to put resource into you just to keep you up, keep you alive, and get you out.
Sure.
Yeah, other than that, solid. Are you playing tomorrow? Like, you're playing tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
Okay,
In
cool.
the tourney.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Should be good. I'm gonna be there, but it's kind of annoying because